Okay, children. So in the last class, we had just started the topic salts, right? How is the salt formed? Vishnupriya, can you tell me?
Neutralization reaction between acids and bases.
Okay. Adidev, what about the products of this neutralization reaction? Products of neutralization reaction. Reaction
salt
between
plus water. Yeah,
very good. Salt plus water. Then, Fia, which part of an acid joins together to form a salt? Anion or cation?
Anion.
Anion from?
Acid and cation from base.
Very good. So we have learned certain salts. And from which acid and which base it is formed, right? So we are going to categorize the salts into different family. Depending upon the cation or anion present in this salt, we can able to classify the salts into different family. So these are the different salts that we discussed in the last class, right? Potassium sulfate, sodium sulfate, calcium sulfate, magnesium sulfate, copper sulfate, sodium chloride, sodium nitrate, sodium carbonate, ammonium chloride, etc. So can you tell me from these salts, can you able to identify any family?
Sulfate.
Yes. First one is sulfate salts. Sulfate. Okay. Yes. Sulfate salts. Because their anionic part contains sulfate. Okay, their anionic part contains sulfate. Then, Melvin, can you tell me which are the sulfate salts among this list?
Potassium sulfate.
Yeah, potassium sulfate. Then?
Magnesium sulfate, copper sulfate.
Yeah.
Sodium.
Still copper sulfate, right? Potassium sulfate, sodium sulfate, calcium sulfate, magnesium sulfate, and copper sulfate. These all belongs to the family of sulfate salts because their anionic part contains sulfates. Clear? Then, Hadiamine, can you tell me another family of salts? Yes. Chloride. Very good. Chloride salts. Chloride salts. Aditya, can you identify chloride salts from this list?
Me?
Can you identify chloride salts from this list?
Sodium chloride.
Yeah. Then?
Ammonium chloride.
Yes, these two belongs to the category of chloride salts. Sainaba?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you tell me any other family from this list?
Sodium nitrate, sodium carbonate.
It belongs to which family? Not only anion, but also cation also categorized into one family. So, it belongs to which type of salts? Sainaba, that's right. Can you tell me the name of this family? Sodium carbonate, then sodium nitrate, sodium chloride. Yes.
Carbonate.
No. Carbonate is not common there. I'm telling the example.
Salts.
Very good. It is sodium salts. Okay. Sodium salts. And the examples for the sodium salts. Sodium chloride, sodium nitrate, sodium carbonate. So based on both cation and anion, we can able to classify the salts into different families. Okay. If the cation is common, we can take it into one family. Then if anion is common, we can take it into another family. In the case of this, yeah, sodium, yeah, one more. Very good. Sodium sulfate. Okay. So these are the different family of salt exist in this list. Sulfate salts, their anionic part contains sulfate ion. The next one, chloride salts, their anionic part contains chloride ion. Then the third one is sodium salt, their cationic part contains sodium. You have to remember always this cation, it is positive part, and anion, it is negative part. Okay. So this cationic part always comes from the base and anionic part always from acid.
Ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, one salt can come in two families.
Yes, same salt can come into different families. Okay. In the case of this sodium sulfate, it belongs to sulfate salts and also sodium salts, right? So we can categorize it into different families based on cation and anion. Clear? Yes. So that's about the activity 2.13. Activity 2.13 in your textbook. Okay, then there is one more activity there, activity 2.14. Before learning this activity, we can learn one more thing. We have learned different types of acids and different types of bases, right? All of you switch on your videos. Adedi, Badra, Surya, Nirubama, Lolita, Aman, Sainaba, Haya, Pratyup, Savio, Meghna, all of you switch on your videos. Yes, we have learned different types of acids and different types of bases. Do you remember that differentiation? Depending upon their strength. Yes, Savio, tell me. Which are the two types of acids?
Concentrated acid, pentylic acid.
Oh, that's another category. Depending upon its strength, depending upon the H plus ion present related to pH value. Anyone? Please tell me different category of acids and bases.
Strong and weak.
Yes, very good. Strong acid and weak acid. Similarly, strong base and weak base, right? In the case of the salt also, we can categorize it into strong salt, weak salt, and neutral salt. Okay? Strong salt, weak salt, and neutral salt. So, next, we are moving to this neutral salts. Okay, neutral salts. Strong acid and strong base combines together. Neutral salts are formed. Okay, if strong acid and strong base undergoes this neutralization reaction, neutral salts are formed. Their pH value is 7. We have learned that for neutral, it is 7, right? So if strong acid and strong base joins together, the result will be a neutral salt. Examples for such neutral salts, NaCl. It is obtained from NaOH base and HCl acid, right? It is obtained from NaOH base and HCl acid. These both belong to the category of strong acid and strong base. This one is an example for strong base. And this is an example for strong acid. Okay, so if strong acid and strong base combines together, a neutral salt is formed. Okay, a strong acid and strong base combines together, neutral salt is formed. This is another example for this neutral salt. This CaOH twice, calcium hydroxide and H2SO4. This also belongs to the strong acid and strong base. H2SO4, it's a strong acid. Then calcium hydroxide, it's a strong base. So here the product formed is a neutral salt. Clear? Do you remember the examples of strong acid and strong base, children? We have learned it in the previous one. Just wait. Yes. Acid give rise to more H plus ions are said to be strong acid. These are the examples. HCl, H2SO4, HNO3, HBr, etc. And for weak acid, H2CO3, that is carbonic acid, then phosphoric acid, that is H3PO4, sulfurous acid, H2SO3, acetic acid, CH3COOH. Okay. Then for strong base, it is sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, lithium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, etc. Then weak base, magnesium hydroxide, ammonium hydroxide, etc. That we already learned. So based on this strength of acid and base, we can able to categorize the salts into different types. A strong acid and strong base combines together, a neutral salt is formed. This is clear for you? A strong acid and strong base combines together, neutral salt is formed. And you have to remember its pH value is always 7 because the products are neutral, right? Then can you tell me how this acidic, that means strong, just one minute, acidic salt, yes. Acidic salt is formed. Yeah. Yeah, did they?
And then this is strong acid.
Your voice is not clear for me. Once again.
When weak base and strong acid.
Very good. Yeah, that's it. A strong acid and weak base combines together, acidic salts are formed. Okay, so that's the next category, acidic salts. Acidic salts. A strong acid and weak base combines together, acidic salts are formed. No need to write this example, okay? It comes under the neutral salt. Strong acid and weak base combines together, acidic salts are formed. And their pH value is less than 7. Okay? Because it is acidic, that's why the pH value is less than 7. You can write the example, NH4Cl. It's formed from NH4OH, that's the base, and HCl, that's the acid. This one is a weak base. Weak base. This is a strong acid. Strong acid. So acidic salts are formed from strong acid and weak base. Their pH value is always less than 7 because they are acidic in nature. Example, NH4Cl. NH4Cl. This is clear? Yes? Here it is Cl, right? That's why it belongs to HCl. If it is SO4, we can write H2SO4. Yeah, Melvin? Just 1 minute. Your voice is too low for me.
Can you say the name? No, H2SO4. The name, can you say?
Name of H2SO4, right?
It's not.
That is sulfuric acid. Or HCl?
No.
H2SO4. Okay. H2SO4 is sulfuric acid. HCl, that is hydrochloric acid. Okay. Then the next category is basic salts. Okay, basic salts. Strong base and a weak acid combines together to form this basic salt. Okay, strong base and a weak acid. Here this pH value is more than 7 because it is basic in nature, right? So the pH value is more than 7. Example, CaCO3. CaCO3. Here the base is CaOH twice. This is a strong base. Strong base. And the next one, the acid, that is H2CO3, carbonic acid. Carbonic acid. Can you tell me from which acid and which base the CH3COONa is formed? CH3COONa. Which acid and which base?
Ammonium
acid.
Yeah, acetic acid. So you got ammonium. Ammonium is NH3, right? Here it is CH3COONa, acetic acid. It is CH3COH. It's a weak acid. Okay? It's a weak acid. Yes. Then what about the base? What about the base, children? NaOH. Okay, NaOH. It's a strong base. So if the salt is formed from a strong base and weak acid, the nature of salt is basic. If the salt is formed from a strong acid and weak base, the nature of salt is acidic. If both strong acid and strong base join together to form a salt, it is neutral in nature. So these are the three categories. Melvin, can you please mute? Yes. So these are the three categories of salts depending upon their nature. First one, neutral salt. It is formed from strong acid and strong base. Second one, acidic salts. It's from strong acid and weak base. Okay. Then the third one is basic salt. It is formed from weak acid and strong base. Okay. You have to remember the pH values also. Clear, children? All of you, please switch on your videos. Yes. Okay, then tell me, which are the three types of salts according to their nature? Pia, can you tell me?
Yes, ma'am. Basic salt, acidic salt, neutral salt.
Yes, neutral salt, acidic salt, and basic salt. Okay, so these are the three types of salts based upon their nature. Then, Vishnupriya, can you tell me from which type of acid and base acetic salt is formed? Acetic salt.
Strong acid and weak base.
Very good. Strong acid and weak base. What about the pH value of neutral salt? Hey, Steve, what's the pH value of neutral salt?
pH value of neutral salt, 7.
Very good. It's 7. Okay. Then next one is basic salt. How this basic salt is formed? Nirubama?
Strong acid and weak base.
Basic salt. Basic.
Acid and strong base.
Yes. Strong base and weak acid. Okay. Strong base and weak acid. Then what about the pH value of this basic salt? Aditya, is Krishna? What about the pH value of basic salt? Is it 7, less than 7, or greater than 7? Aditya? Can you hear me? All of you speak. Yeah, John Samuel, you can tell me.
Ma'am, it's more than 7.
Yes, it's more than 7. pH value is more than 7 for the basic salt. And what about the pH value of acidic salts, Rizwan? Acidic salts.
Yes, ma'am. It is below 7.
Yes, less than 7. So these are the main three categories of salt. Neutral salt, acidic salt and basic salt. Okay, neutral salt is formed from strong acid and strong base. We have learned so many examples for strong acid and strong base, right? Can you give some examples for strong acid?
Sulfuric acid.
Okay, sulfuric acid. Rifa, can you tell me another example? Strong acid. Rifa? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Examples for strong acid.
Ma'am, hydrochloric acid.
Yes, hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acid. These all are examples of strong acid. Okay. If strong acid and strong base combines together, neutral salts are formed. Examples for strong base, sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide, etc. And if strong acid and weak base is combined together, the salt formed is acidic in nature. Okay. And if strong base and weak acid combines together, the salt is basic in nature. Okay. I think now this is clear for you. Do you have any doubt, children?
No, ma'am.
Nothing, right? Okay. Then we are moving to another activity in your textbook. That is activity 2.14. Now we just learned how this formation of salt from respective acid and base, right? We have learned how this acid is formed. Sorry, salt is formed from respective acid and base, right? Here, this activity 2.14, page number 29. Activity 2.14, page number 29.
Yes, ma'am.
Ashik, can you please read this activity?
Yes, ma'am. Collect the following salt sample: sodium chloride, potassium nitrate, aluminium chloride, zinc sulfate, copper sulfate, sodium acetate, sodium carbonate, and sodium hydrocarbonate.
Hydrogen carbonate. We can write the names of salts. Just wait. It's one by one. First one is sodium chloride, right? Sodium chloride. That we already discussed. So can you tell me what about the nature of the salt? Is it neutral, acidic, or basic? Tell me. Sodium chloride. Can you tell me from which acid and which base the salt is formed?
Sodium.
NaOH and H2SO4.
Now it is chloride here, so not H2SO4.
Cl.
Which acid?
Cl.
HCl, not Cl. Okay. So this is an example for a strong base, right? This is an example for a strong base. This is an example for a strong acid. So now you can tell me, is it belongs to acidic one or neutral one?
Neutral,
because strong acid and strong base combines together to form a neutral salt. So in the textbook, you can mark that it's a neutral salt. Neutral salt. So this is the first sample. Ashik, then the second one.
Potassium nitrate.
Yes, it is potassium nitrate. Potassium nitrate. So, who will tell you from which acid and which base the salt is formed? Hadi Amin, can you tell me? Hadi Amin?
Yes, ma'am.
From which acid and which base the salt is formed? Yeah. This first portion that belongs to the base and the second portion belongs to acid. So you can tell me. Yes. Okay, I will give you one more clue for that. In the case of bases, okay, all bases ends with OH ions, OH minus ions. Okay, all bases ends with OH minus ions. So you have to skip that part and take the remaining portion. If it is sodium hydroxide, you can skip that hydroxide part, then sodium. That's needed for the salt. If it is potassium hydroxide, you can skip the hydroxide part and you can take that potassium. Okay, that's the easy way to identify this cationic part from base.
KOH plus HNO3.
It's KOH. Okay. KOH. Because here it is potassium, right? We can skip this OH part. Then remaining portion is K. That is potassium. Then the second one from the acid. It is HNO3. HNO3. So can you tell me, is this acid and base belongs to strong category or weak one?
Potassium is strong.
Both are strong. Okay. This one is an example for a strong base. Next one is an example for strong acid. Okay. So here the product formed
neutral
is
neutral salt.
Very good. Neutral salt is formed. Neutral salt. So for the second one, you can write that it is neutral in nature. Neutral in nature. First one, sodium chloride. It's also an example for a neutral salt because it is formed from a strong acid and strong base. Second one, potassium nitrate. It's also from a strong acid and strong base. That is HNO3, that is nitric acid. Then KOH, that is potassium hydroxide. Clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Then the next one, third one. Shall I move to next one?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Rizwan, which is the third one? Which is the third salt in the activity 2.14?
Yes, ma'am.
Which is the third one? This one. Any network issues? Okay, Vishnupriya, can you tell me the name of third salt?
Aluminium chloride.
Yes, it is aluminium chloride. All of you switch on your videos. It is aluminium chloride. Aluminium chloride. So can you tell me from which acid and which base this aluminium chloride is formed? Question 2. Adidev, can you tell me? What's the name of the base?
Yes, ma'am.
What's the name of the base here? I told you first part from the base. So you can skip the hydroxide part, then tell me the remaining. So you can able to identify from which base it is formed. Just join these two, aluminium, then hydroxide. Adidev, you can join the first part of the salt and along with that, you can add hydroxide. So you can tell me. Yeah, that's it. Aluminium hydroxide. Then what about the acid? Yeah.
Chloride.
Which chloride? Not simply chloride. No, it's from the acidic part, right? Which are the acids present? What's the name of the acid?
HCl.
H2SO4, HNO3, acetic acid, that is CH3COH, then carbonic acid, H2CO3, etc. So you can tell me this chloride, it belongs to which acid? HCl, that's it. Okay, so it is hydrochloric acid, HCl. These also belongs to strong base and strong acid. strong acid. So can you tell me the nature of salt?
Neutral.
Neutral. This one is also an example for neutral salt. Neutral salt. Savio, can you read the next salt? Yeah.
Zinc sulfate.
Zinc sulfate. Zinc sulfate. So Savio, you can tell me from which acid and which base the salt is formed. It is zinc sulfate. You have to remember first portion from the base and the second portion from the acid. Yes. Yes, Savio. Just wait. Savio, you can tell me now. You have to just add this hydroxide part along with this first part. And tell me.
Zinc hydroxide.
Yeah, that's it. Zinc hydroxide. What about the acid? Here it is sulfate. So, which acid? Sulfate. Sulfate from which acid, Savio? Unmute and tell me.
Sulfate.
Just remember the name of acid. Hydrochloric. Sulfuric. Yeah, H2SO4. Okay. Sulfuric acid. No, sulfuric acid. Children, all of you just listen here. In the case of base, okay, in the name itself, it ends with hydroxide. Okay. So in the formation of an salt, you can skip that hydroxide part and you can write the remaining. If it is potassium hydroxide, you can write potassium from that base and you can join it with salt. If it is sodium hydroxide, you can skip that hydroxide part and take sodium from that base and to for the formation of the salt. Okay. And in the case of acid, all acid ends with the name acid. It is hydrochloric acid, then sulfuric acid, acetic acid, nitric acid, etc. And all acids can able to produce H plus ions. Okay, so first of all, you have to remember the names of acids and bases. And you can just categorize this acids into strong acids, weak acids, strong bases, weak bases. Then only you can able to form this salt based upon their nature. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Also an example for a neutral salt. What's the reason?
Because both are strong acid and base.
Yes, both are strong. That means here it is strong base. Next one is an example for strong acid. Strong acid. Okay. Melvin, can you read the next one? Melvin? Yeah.
Copper sulfate.
Yeah, it is copper sulfate. Copper sulfate. So can you tell me from which acid and which base it is formed? You have to remember the first portion from the... Wait. The first portion from the base and the second portion from the acid. Okay, Melvin, so you have to tell me from which base and which acid it is formed.
Sulfuric acid.
Yes, sulfuric acid, that's right. Then what about the base? Yeah, what
copper.
About the base? Copper.
Copper.
What about the remaining portion? Copper, that's
copper.
Right.
Copper.
Bases always ends with which ion?
Copper, COH.
Yeah, that is copper hydroxide. COH twice. Okay. Copper hydroxide, that's right. Copper hydroxide. Here the sulfuric acid is an example for a strong acid. Then copper hydroxide, it's an example for a weak base. So Melvin, can you tell me which type of salt is formed here? Strong acid and weak base. Okay, strong acid and weak base. So is it acidic, basic or neutral? Very good. It is acidic. Acidic salt is formed. Acidic salt is formed.
Yes,
have you completed, children?
Yes, ma'am.
All of you? Okay, then we are moving to next question. Meghna, can you read the next one? Meghna? What's the name of the salt?
Sodium.
Acetate, right? That is sodium acetate. Anjita, can you tell me from which acid and which base this one is formed?
Sodium hydroxide and yes. Acetic acid.
Very good. Sodium hydroxide and acetic acid. Acetic acid. So can you tell me this acetic acid belongs to which category? Strong acid or weak acid? Acetic acid. Is it strong acetic acid?
Weak acid.
It's an example for weak
acid. Weak acid.
Yeah, it's an example for weak acid. So all of you first learn this examples for strong acids, weak acids, strong bases and weak bases. Okay, then only you can able to identify as it belongs to as a strong one or weak one. Okay, then what about the nature of sodium hydroxide? Is it strong or weak?
Strong.
Yes, it's a strong. Very good. It's a strong base. Yes. So what about the nature of the salt? Strong base and acidic. Strong base and weak acid. Here the base is strong. Base is strong. So?
Basic.
Very good. It's basic salt. So you have to practice more questions. Then you will get an idea about how to identify the acid and base and how to categorize it into neutral, acidic or basic. Anjita, what about the next one? Name of the next salt?
Sodium hydroxide.
Not sodium hydroxide. Look at the
text. Sorry.
Yeah. Okay. You can read. Sodium.
Sodium carbonate.
Yes, sodium carbonate. That's it. Rifa, can you tell me? From which acid and which base it is formed?
Sodium hydroxide.
Yeah, sodium hydroxide. Next one?
Calcium.
It's carbonate. So this
form. Carbonic acid.
Yes, it's carbonic acid. Okay. Carbonic acid. What's the chemical formula of carbonic acid? It is H2CO3. That's the acid present in soda water. Okay. That's the acid present in soda water. So what about the nature of this base and acid? Rifa?
Ma'am.
Yeah. Strong base. Then what about this acid?
Weak acid.
Yes. Very good. Plus weak acid. So what about the nature of the salt? Is it acidic?
Basic.
Yes. Just basic in nature. Basic salt. Okay. And the last one is sodium hydrogen carbonate. It also belongs to the same category of acid and base. Sodium hydroxide and carbonic acid. Okay, this is clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now I think you can able to identify the strong acid or strong base and the nature of the salt, right? I will repeat the points once again. Neutral salt is always formed from strong acid and strong base. Okay, acidic salts always formed from strong acid and weak base. Then basic salt is always formed from a strong base and weak acid. First of all, you have to learn the examples for the strong acids, strong bases, weak acid, weak bases. Okay, then you know the name of a salt, you have to remember the first portion. That means the cationic part, the positive part, that's from the base. And the negative part or the anionic part, that's from the acid. So in the case of all bases, it ends with hydroxide or OH minus ion. So you have to skip that part and take the first part for the formation of salt. Then in the case of acids, all acids ends with the name acid, hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid. So you have to skip that H plus ion and take the remaining portion. From HCl, we just take Cl, right? Then H2SO4, we just take SO4 for the formation of salt. Now I think it's clear for you, right? Yes. So that's about this activity. Then one more question there. Check their solubility in water. All these acids are soluble in water. Okay. All these acids are soluble in water. Then we just identified the salt are acidic, basic or neutral through this activity. Is this clear? Do you have any doubt, children? Nothing, right? Okay. Then just wait. Let me take your attendance. Okay. Thank you, children. All of you read this portion very well. Okay. Thank you all. See you in the next class. Thank you.